Erev Shabbat Kodesh, Shushan Purim. One of the most important principles of Judaism, really, and of the Jewish year, is precisely what we read on Purim. Zachor et asher asa lecha Amalek. Remember what Amalek did to you. Timche et zecher Amalek. Wipe out the remembrance of Amalek. What was Amalek? Who was Amalek? And what it seems when we say Timche et Zecher Amalek, it's telling me that it's not a specific race or people, but Amalek is an ideology. It's Amalekiut. That's why it says Timche et Zecher Amalek. Again, it's not a specific nation. It's the ideology of any nation that does what was done to us when we were still escaping Egypt, on the way first to Eretz Yisrael. And the Torah defines, describes Amalekiut. Asher korcha baderech, they chanced upon you on the road. V'yizanev b'cha kol ha-necheshalim acharecha. And they try to undercurrent and destroy the stragglers amongst you. V'yata ayef v'yageya, the weaker vessels amongst the Jewish people, the infirm, the sick and the old, the children, the pregnant women. V'lo yare Elokim. They had no fear of God. The God who says, Lo tirtzach, you shall not kill, and especially not the helpless, whom you must help. V'haya ba'aniach Hashem Elokecha lecha mikol oyevecha misaviv. When you'll be left alone from all of your enemies round about, ba'aretz, within Eretz Yisrael, timche et zecher Amalek mitachat ha-shamayim. You must destroy even the memory of Amalek, the ideology of Amalek, Amalekiut, from the midst of the earth. The most important question facing us as Jews today, that thank God we have a state of Israel, and developing very, very well. The greatest question facing us is our job, our task, to be a mamlechet kohanim v'goy kadosh, a kingdom of priest teachers and a holy nation, to teach the world. And at that time, our lesson must be to remove Amalekiut, the ideology of Amalek, within the world. This is our test. What's really facing us as Jews, now that we have Medinat Yisrael, we have not achieved our ultimate goal. Because the world still is not a world that accepts the kingship of a God of morality. We're still not a world that understands the importance of beating our swords into pruning hooks and making certain that this is a world of peace and not of warfare. That's our task today. The most important task we have. And it's not anti-Semitism anymore. We have to make certain that this world is a world of peaceful nations on the way to worshiping the God of justice and compassion, the God of love of humanity, the God of peace. And we are now being tested. In a war which is not against us, in a war which is against Ukraine, at this moment, and at the next moments, will be against Kiev. And Amalek, who's named Russia, and Amalek, were going into a country that didn't want to fight him. An independent country that only wanted peace. And Amalek wanted to destroy this nation simply because it had more power, or thought it had more power, than Ukraine. And thought it would be over in a few days. Because it was great, powerful Russia against a smaller Ukraine. Turned out to take more time. Ukraine really fought against Russia for its freedom. And it's not only NATO. It also has to be Israel. It has to be every nation that believes that the goal should be peace and that might does not make right, but that a mighty nation, most of all, has to be a nation that believes in a world of peace. In a world in which the weak are helped, not destroyed, because of their weakness. We were almost failing on this test. And we seemed not to be taking in what our share should be of taking in people who are in trouble, as Ukraine, because of mighty Russia. Now, thank God, We are helping them tremendously. And we really, really have come forth as the one nation of all nations that is trying desperately to make peace between Russia and Ukraine and all of the enemies who are weaker that Russia will try to take up and destroy. Hopefully, we will win. But the most important thing, we dare not be on the side of Amalek. Amalek now is Russia. The next generation, it may, God forbid, be China. But Israel must always do its share to fight against Amalekiut, which is against the weaker vessels. We have to protect the weaker vessels as much as we can, whether they are Jews or whether they are Gentiles. They're human beings, and we must always be on the side of the innocent human beings who are being undercut by the more powerful nations. That is our task today, that we are an independent nation of strength. Shabbat Shalom Mevorach.